Hi, let's talk about the heart and its position within the thoracic cavity. In this video, we'll introduce the heart, we'll describe where the heart is located, we'll also discuss the organization of the thoracic cavity and the mediastinum within the thoracic cavity. So the heart is the central organ for the cardiovascular system. Blood moves according to pressure, and the heart is what provides the bulk of the pressure within the cardiovascular system. The engine that drives this pump is the myocardium, and that myocardium is rich with cardiac muscle tissue. An individual's heart is roughly the size of their loosely closed fist. Typically, this is going to weigh 200 to 300 grams, depending on the body type. And the heart is going to occupy the middle mediastinum within the thoracic cavity. The heart as an organ is hopefully ever working. You know, it is one of the first organs to functionally come online. It begins its beating about the third week of development and, you know, completes its mission upon the death of its owner, perhaps not in the case of an organ transplant, but you know, for a person's lifespan, the heart continues to beat. So the heart is found within the thoracic cavity, and the thoracic cavity is the space which is bounded laterally by the ribs and the intercostal spaces, superiorly by the root of the neck. And the root of the neck, as it transitions into the thoracic cavity, is above the level of rib one, inferiorly by the diaphragm, posteriorly by the vertebral column, and anteriorly by the sternum. Now, within the thoracic cavity, there are three spaces. Laterally, we have what are known as the pulmonary cavities. And these pulmonary cavities are going to contain the lungs and the serous membranes which encase them, called the pleurae. Medial to the lungs is a region called the mediastinum. So roughly, this outline here is the mediastinum. That mediastinum is going to contain the pericardium, and within the pericardium, the heart. It's going to contain neurovasculature, in particular, the great vessels of the heart. It's going to contain viscera, such as the lower limit sometimes of the thyroid gland, that can be in there, the thymus gland, various lymph nodes, the esophagus, the trachea, and the primary bronchi. Now, when we look at the mediastinum, we could further subdivide it into four spaces. The first division is going to be between the superior mediastinum and the remainder of the space. Now keep in mind that laterally the mediastinum is bordered by the pleural cavities. The pulmonary cavities, and within them the pleurae and the pleural cavities. So at the level of the sternal angle, the sternal angle is where the manubrium meets the body of the sternum. If you were to palpate your own sternum, you can sometimes feel this convex ridge. That's your sternal angle. It's an important landmark. That's precisely where rib 2 articulates with the sternum. And if we were to draw a plane posteriorly, extending to about the intervertebral disc between the fourth and the fifth thoracic vertebra, that plane would divide the superior mediastinum from the remainder of the mediastinum. Now, keep in mind that that first rib is the plane for the superior mediastinum. So there's kind of a wedge-shaped superior mediastinum. The quote-unquote inferior mediastinum actually is three separate spaces. There's an anterior, a middle, and a posterior mediastinum. These divisions are all based on the pericardium. The pericardium here is outlined in red, and wherever the pericardium is, that represents the middle mediastinum. Anything anterior to the pericardium is the anterior mediastinum. Anything posterior to the pericardium is the posterior mediastinum. And you should be able to see here that, you know, the diaphragm is a rather arching structure. It doesn't go, you know, flat across as a lot of people presuppose. And so that posterior mediastinum has a significant amount of depth compared to the middle or the anterior mediastinum. That goes down quite far. And this leads us to the assessment question for the video, and that is, what space within the thorax contains the heart? Is it the anterior mediastinum, the middle mediastinum, the posterior mediastinum, the pulmonary cavity, or the superior mediastinum? Well, hopefully you understand that the heart is surrounded by the pericardium, and the pericardium defines where the middle mediastinum exists. So wherever the pericardium is that middle mediastinum. Therefore, the heart must be found within the middle mediastinum. Thank you very much for your time.